शुक्लां वरदरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द भगवद्गीता। Last week, we have last class, we discussed about the context of the Bhagavad Gita. The Bhagavad Gita, which appears in the Mahabharata, in the Bhishma Parva, which is the sixth book of the Mahabharata, and the third section and 23rd chapter to 29 or 40 up to 40 it goes. Last week, last class, I told about the context. Mainly the Mahabharata is focused on the two family, one is Kauravas, another is Pandava. So Kauravas father is Dhritarashtra, who is a blind man, he is elder son, elder brother, and his brother name is called Pandu. The Pandu sons are called Pandavas. Really speaking, both are Kauravas only, because they are belongs to Kuru Vamsa. It's a lineage of the Kuru Vamsa. So Kuru Vamsa, they, since they are coming in the lineage of the Kuru Vamsa, these all people, the Dhritarashtra, Pandu, both are called Kuru Vamsa Kauravas. So both group are called Kauravas only. But in order to distinguish among the Kauravas, we call Dhritarashtra sons are called Kauravas and Pandu sons are called Pandavas. So the thing is, I told last week, in the game of the dice, Pandavas were defeated, Kauravas won the game and came to the power. The Pandavas sent to the forest for 13 years. And 14th years, they supposed to live in exile, and they lived exile 1 year, and they came back. Since they are all following the dharma, after 14th year, they came and asked, "Please give our land back." Duryodhana, who is the elder brother of the Kauravas. The Kauravas were 100 brothers, and there is one sister, so totally 101. The Duryodhana, he is not ready to give the land because he already enjoyed 14 years of the power. Once you enjoy the power, the position, the respect from the people, it's very difficult to give it to somebody else because it's another kind of a kick, you know. It's called a fame and name kick. You know, people are taking the alcohol and smoke, some kind of addiction. This name and fame also kind of addiction. So here, Duryodhana and his brothers are addicted to this kind of name and fame. So once they tasted the power, they are not at all ready to give up the land to the Pandavas. Then Pandavas, especially the Yudhishthira, who is elder brother of the Pandavas, or Dharmaputra, he is not interested to the war. He is always go for the debate, compromise, some value, because he doesn't like war. Because after all, these Kauravas are their own cousins. So they went to such an extent to compromise. First, they asked the kingdom, please give our kingdom. Then the Kauravas refused. And they asked, at least give the 5 village. Kauravas said, no. Then they asked, at least give the 5 palace, that's enough. Kauravas said, no chance. Even I am not going to give the place which occupied by the pin. You know, that is a pin, the needle, the tip of the needle. You can keep it, how much the land which will occupy. It's the smallest space. That Pandavas asked a small place. Kauravas totally refused. But still, Pandavas not at all ready to go and fight with them. They tried their best. They send the Krishna, Lord Krishna, as a messenger, as an ambassador. Please, Krishna, you go and convince this Duryodhana and brothers. At least ask them to give the small piece of the land. Krishna told, do you think they will give? They said, no, we are trying our best. It's not, we have this some scope, some hope on you. When you go and talk with the Kauravas, they may listen to you. Because since you are uncle of both sides, you are a god of the gods. So definitely, they will listen. This is what Dhritarashtra, the Yudhishthira, the Dharmaputra told. And Krishna told, I don't think so. But Yudhishthira asked the Lord Krishna, please, you go. We request you. I request you, please, you go as an ambassador. Krishna went. And he went and talked. As usual, reply from the Duryodhana, he said, no. And Krishna was talking about, please give it to them. Krishna tried his best to convince and ask them, please give them. Then Krishna told, if you don't give their own kingdom, definitely there'll be a war in this fight. You all people will be destroyed. That will be sure. because Krishna got angry now. People are thinking, Krishna will never get angry. This is because since Lord Krishna is incarnation of Lord Vishnu, people are thinking Krishna is always smiling face with the flute. Never. Krishna also got angry. Krishna also got upset. Krishna also got the love for the people. Krishna also, he did his duty as a Kshatriya duty, so fight. In this context also, Krishna really got angry with Duryodhana. And he told, there will be fight. You all will be destroyed. You all people, you are adharmic people. Definitely you are all destroyed by the Pandavas, because Pandavas are dharmikas. Where the dharma is there, definitely dharma will win. You will be destroyed. This is sure. Then Duryodhana and Shakuni, they plan to tie up the Krishna. And they were tying the Krishna, because from Duryodhana's side, they always consider Krishna as just a man, like anybody else. But only the Dharma, Dharmaputra and the Pandavas, only they knew very well about that Krishna is not an ordinary man. Krishna is born as a man. He is a God itself. He is just Sakshat, nothing but Lord Vishnu itself, as a born as a human being. But these kind of things are not there for Duryodhana. So he thought he is Krishna is not like any normal man. They tied in the post Krishna. Then Krishna, this is a time for him to show who he is. Then Krishna appeared, Vishwarupa. Vishwarupa means what? He showed his real nature. That means in this body, entire world, entire creation, entire galaxy, sun, moon, war, all people are there. He showed, Krishna showed this thing to the Duryodhana. But unfortunately, Duryodhana and his brothers, they thought Krishna is a magician. And that time also they could not recognize the Lord Krishna. Krishna is not ordinary person. He is a God himself itself. That recognition was not there. And finally, he showed the whole thing, the whole Hastinapura. The Hastinapura means the place where the palace, the Duryodhana, before the Duryodhana, Dharmaputra was ruling the kingdom. Before that, the Dhritarashtra was ruling. That Hastinapura, the kingdom, the place, like a city, it's a big city. The whole city Hastinapura is trembled because of the Krishna showed his Vishwarupam. Vishwarupam means the big form of the Krishna. And himself came out of the tying, where the Duryodhana tied, he came out and he got angry and he told Duryodhana, you all are going to die in the mouth of the Lord Death. You are already dead. You are gone, finished. These Pandavas, the Bhima is going to kill everybody. This is sure. This is what, with a lot angry, Krishna went to the Dharmaputra, where the Pandavas are there. Krishna was so angry. And there is a Dharmaputra and all five brothers were waiting for the Krishna's message. They're sitting. And they are very curiously, they ask the Krishna, what happened? Please tell. He is accepted to king the five place or five houses or what? Then Krishna was really angry I told Dharmaputra, he won't agree. Now it's inevitable. There is a war. Nobody can stop it now because now Duryodhana is ready, prepared to fight with you. The war only the solution for this problem. So now that is it. War only the final. Krishna told with angry and he left to his Dwarka, where the Krishna was ruling. Dwarka at present, you know, the Gujarat state, where he was ruling the, his own kingdom. The Ayodhya, where it is now, it is Uttar Pradesh, Uttaraka, yeah, it's Uttar Pradesh. In Uttar Pradesh, this Hastinapura, where the Kauravas were ruling. So from that he told and he left with angry. And Duryodhana preparing the support, you know, he went all over the country and he collected the supporters who are going to support me. They, because they declared, the war is declared. There is a declaration of the war between the Pandavas and the Kauravas. So both groups started to gain the support. Like in our modern world, now, you know, if some country is doing something and some country is supporting this country and all other countries are supporting another country. Like the same way, in Mahabharata time also, the Pandavas started to collect the supporters from all over the country. Kauravas also started to collect their supporters. So both sides they collected. And the Dhritarashtra and Dhritarashtra and Shakuni, they told Duryodhana, Duryodhana, please go ask support from Lord Krishna, because Dhritarashtra knows very well Lord Krishna is Lord himself. Shakuni also knows very well Krishna is the incarnation of the Vishnu. Unfortunately, the Duryodhanas, the brothers, they could not realize the fact. So they told Duryodhana, the Dhritarashtra and Shakuni, please go and get the support from the Lord Krishna. Somehow he doesn't like, but since the elder people forced him, so he went to the Dwarka to get the support from the Krishna. The same time, from the Pandava side, Arjuna also went to the Dwarka to get the support from the Krishna. Fortunately or unfortunately, before Duryodhana reached Dwarka to meet Krishna, Arjuna was sitting there in the feet of the Lord Krishna, because that time Krishna was lay down on the bed. He was sleeping because Arjuna reached the Dwarka early morning, 3 o'clock or something, and he was sitting there. After half an hour, 3:30 or 4 o'clock, Duryodhana also went reach the place. Arjuna is folding the hand like that and sitting at the feet of the Lord Krishna. And Duryodhana sitting nearby the head of the Lord Krishna. Krishna woke up. When he woke up, he saw Arjuna was sitting at the feet of the Krishna. Oh, Krishna immediately asked, oh, what, Arjuna, what is this? Why this early morning you are here? What for? By the time, Duryodhana also drawn his attention from Krishna like like that. is coughing. And Lord Krishna looked at this side, the head side, and there is the Duryodhana also sitting there. And Krishna told, "Oh, Duryodhana, you too have come here. That's great to see you two people are sitting here waiting." You know, one thing, very interesting thing is Krishna, when he went as an ambassador to the Hastinapura for the sake of the Pandavas, Krishna came back with a lot of angry with Duryodhana. Now Krishna is totally different. That moment, how he is supposed to react, he reacted. Because Krishna is not angry with Duryodhana as a person. Krishna is anger with only that particular behavior. That's why Krishna was angry that time by the behavior of the Duryodhana. Now Krishna is very calm, very quiet. Now when he looked at Duryodhana, he didn't get angry. "Oh, that day I told you, you didn't listen. Why you came here? What for you are sitting here?" No, he didn't ask such questions. Because that is the nature of the wise people. Wise people always, in that moment, they may get angry or upset. The next moment, they will forget. Because they don't have this kind of revenge or kind of vengeance or this kind of emotions in their mind for the long time. That's what happened in this situation. When you looked at the Duryodhana, Krishna was just a smiling face. He asked, "Oh, Duryodhana, you two sitting here, both have come here. Do you have the tea? Have you had the chai? People have given the chai or coffee." Then they said, "It's okay. We have come for you. It's okay. Later we can have the breakfast with you." "And what for you two people have come?" Then Arjuna told, "Now you know that war is inevitable. So we need the support. We need support from you. I need your support." This is what Arjuna told. And Duryodhana also told the same thing. "We want your support." Then the situation, both people want Krishna's support, but Krishna has to support. Krishna told, "Okay, since you both people have come to me to get support from me, I have decided to support you. See, I am one side. I will stand one side. In this war, I am not going to use any more weapon at all. And another side, I am keeping the Narayana army. The army which is the Lord Krishna's army is called Narayana. So the army which is a very powerful army. Nobody can stand in front of this such army. Whoever come against this army, it will be destroyed. Such an army he has, Krishna." Then he told, "I am going to be there one side and my army is going to be other side. So two, you can choose whatever you want. So since I have seen the Arjuna first, and also Arjuna is younger than Duryodhana, so I have the choice to the younger person to choose first." Now this is what in India still the Indian culture we are following. In the family also, when you want to divide the property, always the younger brother will choose the first. Whatever he wants, he will choose the first. And whatever the left, he will be given to the elder brother. That's what from the Mahabharata period it started. So here also Krishna told, since the Arjuna is younger and also I saw Arjuna first, I give the opportunity, the choice to the Arjuna first. Arjuna, look at here. I am Krishna. Without army, I will stand one side. And my army, which is a very powerful army, the Narayana army, will be the other side. You can choose what you want. Arjuna doesn't have the second thought. Immediately it came, I need you. I need only Krishna. That's it. I don't want anything. And also, Duryodhana also equally very happy. Wow! Because Krishna is without weapon. He is not going to fight in the battlefield. Such a person one side. And there is a Narayana army. Such a big army is there. Nobody can fight with them. Such army is stand other side. One side is empty-handed Krishna. Then Duryodhana thought, oh, Arjuna is really fool to choose the weaponless, not fighting such a Krishna as a support. So Duryodhana was so happy because that is what he wanted. During that time, Duryodhana was praying, oh, I want only Narayana army, Narayana army. Arjuna should not choose the Narayana army. He is supposed to choose only the Krishna. I want Narayana army. It worked. Arjuna choose Krishna. Duryodhana was very happy because the left out is the Narayana army. Both are happy. Krishna also happy. Arjuna also happy. Duryodhana also happy. So happily they left. See, that is what is the greatest the thing of the God's grace, you know. That Krishna has such a mind, such a person to make everybody to be happy. The consequence is different because Duryodhana thought, when I have the Narayana army, I am going to win the war. But he could not. But this is what happened. So all both left. Immediately Duryodhana left the Dwarka and he took the army to the Hastinapura. And Arjuna was staying there because he wanted to have talk with Krishna. And he stayed back. And Krishna told to Arjuna, Arjuna, are you fool? What you did? You're supposed to choose the Narayana army, which is very powerful. I'm not going to fight in this battlefield. Why you have chosen me as your support? Arjuna smiled at Krishna. Krishna, I know you. I don't want anything. I want only the grace. Because Arjuna has 100% confident on his side. Definitely in this war he is going to fight and he is going to win. Only thing, he needs the grace. He needs the grace of the God. You know, he has the all powers. Because during the 14 years of the time, I think time's up. I will conclude this session. You know, during the 14 years, he collected a lot of weapons, all kind of weapons. So he has total confidence on himself, on the Pandava side. But only thing he needs the grace. The grace is Lord Krishna. This is the main game challenging. No, they say the game changer. The game changer is here, the Lord Krishna. He knows himself. Arjuna knows very well about himself. Only he need the game changer. Who is that? That is Lord Krishna. That's what he told. I need only you. I don't want army. Even I can defeat your army very easily. This is what Arjuna's power. Arjuna is not an ordinary man. He can single-handedly, he can defeat easily this Narayana army. That much confident, that much weapons he had it. That's why he has chosen the Lord Krishna as his support. That means our effort is 50% and God's grace is the 50% will win the game. It will change the way of the game. With that, we see in the next session. With that, I will want to conclude. Let us see what happened to the in the battlefield on Thursday. Thank you so much. Arigato gozaimasu. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Thank you so much. Please take care of everybody. Stay home. Take care. Thank you so much. Yes, please. Thank you so much. After tomorrow. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.